And welcome everyone here in Twitch chat and everybody on YouTube for some Katarina burn. Gonna bring this deck back. Played this a week ago and it was a lot of fun, pretty impressive. Burn decks in general and just hyper aggro like this isn't really in the best spot right now in Legends of Runeterra. Noxus overall is probably the weakest region, but there's just a lot of good defensive options. And with cards like Brood Awakening, sorry, that's the card that I was thinking of. With that being now a 5-mana card and kind of everywhere getting 3/2/1s, it's really hard to go wide and get that damage in. And then, of course, there's a lot of Withering Wail and Static Shock and all that kind of stuff. A lot of ways that people are ready for cheap creatures. So I don't think this is like one of the best decks. I don't think it's like a tier one, but I think this is a really good burn deck. So especially when you're in the lower, so I think this is a good rank up deck, especially when you're in the lower rate rankings, like where you don't really lose as much rank for a loss as you gain for wins. You can play a lot more matches with a deck like this, but it is fairly competitive. I think it's a pretty close to 500 deck. It's just not like one of the very best options, but we got Katarina in here now, where Katarina gives us just some utility in the late game. You don't really want to play Katarina on turn three, because you do create that fleeting Blade's Edge that costs 1 mana. So you really want to have four. Katarina's secretly a 4-mana spell that's a 3/2 that does 1 damage to anything whenever you play it. And then it has all the other things that it does. But all right, it's enough about the deck. Here we go. Let's try to burn an 8. We'll go to Jinx's place. We'll keep our Poro. Poro's been doing good for us. And let's go burn an 8. Okay. Hey, Rover Split. Yeah, I've been playing Legends of Runeterra instead of Magic. I switched over to this game. Changed the Twitch name so it doesn't have the MTG and the Twitch name anymore. Get rid of Decimate to start with. I guess we'll keep these. I kind of want to get rid of Katarina from the opener, because Katarina is a really good card when you're like ahead, or even to like take you ahead, and a good late game card. But not necessarily a great card to have in your opener, because you can't really have Katarina out in play attacking and everything. And so we know they're playing Draven this turn. I'm basically saving. I'm playing this slow. I know my Blade's Edge is going to kill the biggest fan. If I don't play anything, I could actually have Blade's Edge, Mystic Shot, kill Draven, which is actually a lot more appealing. Yeah, it's actually a lot more appealing. So kill Draven or kill Skitter and Biggest Fan.
Oh,
Man, Gloves Beyond is so good. That is so good. I was kind of planning on going straight to attacks, but kind of decided that probably me playing Grenadier and Boom Crew Rookie is going to be better than what they play. Blocking Katarina? Huh. So I could Mystic Shot to keep them from drawing two cards, but no, we're going to... Yeah, we're going to just kill this big thing and keep my Boom Crew Rookie around. I'll put him down to 10. Wow, okay. I didn't really see that coming, but that works for them. That's a good play. And what they probably, you know, what they don't realize, it's actually better for me to have this Katarina in play for Augmented Experimenter. That actually just helped me out. And I just want to get the Augmented Experimenter out of my hand right now before, like, we start bouncing Katarina and have to worry about it, all that kind of stuff. So yeah, we get rid of a Mystic Shot. But I think it's still worth it. I mean, we're drawing three cards. Not the best three cards. Yeah, not the best three cards. So we're basically even right now. I have a Katarina and four cards, and they have five cards. With all this stuff trading. So now we're a little ahead. Now we both have four cards, but I have a Katarina in play. I feel like I'm the one that's supposed to be playing crowd favorite, not them. Alright, so they definitely are going to be having tricks. I want to have as much life as possible, because they're definitely gonna have like Brothers Bonds, yep, and stuff like that. Like, that's all they have in hand, are just those crappy pump spells. guess I play you. I only get one cost to cast, but I guess that's fine. That should be game. Katarina burn. Gonna win? Maybe. Maybe not. We didn't even have Katarina level up. We attacked with Katarina twice, and she didn't die, and she didn't level up. That is very rare. That is very rare. That's hard to do. Opponent's just upset that they're gonna lose, I guess. They're just burning the. This is what we call roping. They're just burning the rope. No refund. So we gotta wait just a little bit longer. So today was Tuesday, you know, we opened up the vault earlier today. I didn't get anything good. I got one epic total, and I got, you know, like the weekly champion WoW card you get. And then just a bunch of shards. Did anybody else get anything good in their vault? Cause I didn't, so y'all have to get good stuff. But you know, got more shards so that whenever the new set comes out next week. Are y'all ready for that? Next week. That is awesome. A week from today, we're going to have a new set. Then we'll have, you know, more shards to be able to get more of the champions right away. Teemo Heimerdinger. I don't know what this is about, but I like it. You got two Harrowing and the champion wildcard. Nice. Okay. Two epics. Okay. Yeah, the diamond chests are underwhelming, but... The good news is you do get them every single week, and it's honestly just a whole lot of, you know, a whole lot of stuff. A lot of commons really gets your collection, like, really finishes out your collection. But yeah, as far as epics and champions, doesn't give you a ton. That's a sad thermogenic beam. I'm surprised they didn't target the 3-2, but I guess they'd rather me have a 3-1 that can't block than a 2-1 that can block. I could certainly see them having another thermogenic beam. Probably shouldn't play that precious bet. No. Stop scratching my chair. No. RV. I feel good. So waited on the Blade's Edge that I was going to be using to kill the Teemo, because if they would have their pickpocket block a 1-1, then I'd want to be able to Blade's Edge it. Just do some trades.
No one gets in my way.
I'm not sure. I'm not sure if the Ionia champion was released. Check out the Imgur, right? Check out the Imgur today. Nope, nothing released yet today. So, that means, yeah, obviously nothing's gonna be released now. If I get excited that, what would I discard? I guess the Decimate. I have to spend two cards to trade with one of theirs, but they also get two free creatures. Not a good trade for me. But we do have Draven, Katarina. So hopefully they win this game for me. That was a pretty bad trade for me. WQ with that tier 1 sub. Y'all get some hype for WQ, resubbing. Love you, WQ, thank you so much. 3 awesome months now. They just have another Heimerdinger? That's cheating. Difficult to fight through these turrets and get the last damage in. That's a good draw. I like that one. Is that good against a removal spell? Heimerdinger so good. I'm gonna try to level up this Draven with the multiple attacks this turn. That's bad. That's bad news. I mean, I can Like, if I attack with Draven, they block Draven with the T-Hex, but then I can Transfusion and Mystic Shot and then kill the T-Hex. Which I guess that's my best option. Other option is just attack with Katarina. Replay Katarina, just attack with Katarina again, have the Mystic Shot to go there. Force them to, like, chump block with these two things. But then they have a T-Hex that... I guess I can block the T-Hex with this thing. I don't know the deck at all, WQ. You'd have to show it to me. I don't know it. A deck that just got uploaded by somebody else. I've been streaming and stuff. I don't know what that is. Come on, Battle Fury. Too many blockers from Heimerdinger. That's why I used the Get Excited and Decimate to kill the Heimerdinger, but obviously after how that game played out and them having a second Heimerdinger, I really wish I didn't do that and just had those spells go upstairs. I liked my play for one Heimerdinger, but for two Heimerdingers, I didn't like my play. Is there just a list? Can't really watch it. Is there just a... Do you have a list, WQ? Karina Control. No, I don't know the... I don't know what my opponent was really playing. Like, I don't have my opponent's previous list. This likely being a slower match, I'm going to keep the Experimenter. I guess I probably should have... Probably should have discarded the Mystic Shot. If they have Hapless Aristocrat, we lose. Okay, we lose. Yeah, I mean, that's game. It's just such a huge difference whether, you know, like, whether they... If they have Hapless Aristocrat, if they don't. It's a big difference. I should have mulliganed the Mystic Shot. Sorry, I was kind of... preoccupied there. This, yeah. GG's. Hapless Aristocrat is so bad against basically everything, but it's so perfect for this matchup. That's just standalone midrange, right? Fiora Zed? Standalone? They just put in Blade Scout and Green Glade Duo. You just put those two cards in, and Cythria. You know, just changed up like those, like that, just changed that part. Why does he keep calling everything burn? That's not a burn deck. Why, Swim, why does he just call decks burn? Call it Elusive Burn? There's no... Like, I don't know what he thinks the word burn means. I don't understand. there's a lot of decks that he labels as burn, and I just don't get it. We are really dead. We are really dead over here, by the way. Yeah, burn spells are spells that do damage to the opponent. Like, this is burn. Mystic Shot. This is burn. I don't know what he thinks the word burn means. Or like why would he call that a burn deck? Yeah, we are so dead. No, it's not elusive because he calls a lot of other things burns. I don't think it's elusive because he calls this elusive burn. So, like, those are different. I don't think it's because it has elusive creatures, it has burn. I don't think that's it. But I don't know what it is. I think just the word aggro means burn. I think that's what it is. I think just aggressive decks are called burn. That's the only thing I can think of.
I must get out of here.
I think it's because of the relentless pursuits plus buffs to burn opponent in one or two rounds, or like usually one huge round, like one or two attacks. Yeah, but that's not burning the opponent, that's just killing them with damage. Oh well. Katarina control can be really, really good against aggro if they have the right cards, and they certainly did, and I had not the right cards. I had a lot of one toughness things, like my two drops that are one, you know, I need like my two mana 1/4s, not my two mana 3/1s, that kind of stuff. This is just a slaughter in this game. We're still just going through the motions, but this game's been over for a long time. Let's move on. Especially how, like, they take a little bit, pass, I play something, they take a little bit, pass. It's just, we're just gonna waste another, like, you know, 5-6 minutes of life that really doesn't need to be wasted. We had a 0% chance of winning that game. We'll keep this. Use Cast Salesman. Good against other aggressive decks to get us the blockers on turn 3. I like Transfusion as a trick. No one's the wiser. Everybody has their one drop. You know, last opponent had Hapless Aristocrat as their only one drop. They had it. This opponent has Fleet Feather Tracker as their only one drop. They have it. Yeah, I mean... so good. Yeah, the different stage layouts have different music, yep. Yeah, that's the absolute best turn one, turn two combo for that deck. You know, especially attacking on turn two with that, like, that's just perfect. First big mission. We ran into two opponents in a row that have had the perfects, unfortunately. I always forget that with the burst speed spells, I didn't actually attack.
Won't get past me.
New recruit reporting in.
Oh, I guess I have more one drops.
For the glory of Demacia.
Wow. Wow.
I'm ready. No closer.
All right, we could use Augmented Experimenter or Katarina, Draven, you know, like that kind of stuff. You know, Decimate. You know, we can get 11 points of burn. We need our top end. So there's a Decimate to start with. Two, four, five, six, seven, eight. I mean, I think this is just has to be the play, because, like, they're going to eat this. I think it just has to be the play. Like, that's just going to buy me more turns. Yep. Dang, our last two opponents have had everything. And... aggro decks these days can't really beat decks that have everything. So I was talking about aggro is just not in a very good position. It was in a better position when it's when it was just a bunch of, like, you know, Karma Ezreal and slow control decks. But the metagame has gotten faster and tougher to play aggro. Maybe we mulligan these cards. They didn't work out last time. We'll mulligan them this time. Look for champions. Champions are, of course, our most powerful cards. Explosives primed. Keeping the get excited because it kills Ash. And we have to kill Ash. The problem with Pickpocket is I think they were going to be playing like the 3-1. Okay, I thought they were going to have the 3-1. Or just like something to block the Pickpocket. And I kind of felt like maybe if we wait a turn on Pickpocket, we can, you know, set up a... You know, use like Get Excited or something else. Brittle Steel would be the Nightmare, or like basically that or Elixir of Iron. I don't want them to play Ash this turn. Well, that makes my life easy. That Culling Strike made my life very easy. And no Ash, that's good. Good news. Our strength is yours. We're gonna need some cards to discard to get excited. Thought about blocking with the 3-1.
This is our homeland.
Okay, well, so this is 4, 7, 10. So we have 10, so we have 10 direct damage. I think I'd rather have all these things out still. I'm gonna save Draven. Basically, this gives me a lot longer of a clock, or it should. It should take them more time to kill me now. And so we just have more time to get this 14 damage in. Probably have more frostbite stuff, right? I mean, I guess it makes more sense to do the point to Draven. I don't know why we would do it to that. I guess I should have done the point to Draven. Okay. I think that was the right call with the double get excited to the hearth guard with me being able to keep the Draven and keep everything out there. So, you know, we went 2-3. Like I said, this is a pretty 500-ish deck. We did run into two opponents that just had absolutely amazing hands for their deck. They had it all. And this kind of deck doesn't really beat decks that have absolutely amazing hands. You know, with like all of their like 1 and 2 mana cards in their deck, we're gonna really struggle. And that's what we saw here. Got to do a little bit of, you know, we got to do some stuff with Katarina. Katarina was pretty decent. You know, got to do some stuff there. But there we go. That's Katarina burn. I like the, you know, like I like these aggro decks. I like these burn decks, but like I said, they're just not, they're not powerful enough to be winning consistently in this metagame. All right, but anyway, those of y'all watching on YouTube, please hit that like button. And of course, feel free to leave a comment. Let me know if you've been playing any good Noxus aggro decks these days. Let me know in the comments. You know, I'm definitely interested in playing Noxus aggro decks. All right, but that's it here for Katarina Burn. So thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you for the next video.